We can go live now to Rafah in the southern part of Gaza and speak to Al Jazeera's Tamer Al-Mishal, who is there for us. And first of all, tell us more about this airstrike in which three Hamas commanders, quite senior members of the Hamas military wing, were killed.
Yes, I am here in Al-Sultan neighborhood. This neighborhood is in the west part of Rafah in the south Gaza Strip, Rafah city. I will show you the aftermath of this airstrike in the dawn time, around 4 o'clock in the morning. The Israeli F-16 jets have attacked a house. This is the aftermath of this house by 9 rockets in the same time attacked this house, and it has been destroyed completely and damaged in the whole area. 10 people have been killed, according to Palestinian medical sources, three of them the Hamas military wing commanders. Al-Qassam Martyr Brigades, the military wing of Hamas, said the three commanders, their names, Muhammad Abu Shamala, Wara'id Al-Attar, and Muhammad Barhoum. And these three commanders are the most senior commanders of Al-Qassam Brigades in Rafah, and they are well-known names. Especially Israel have tried many times to attack and kill and assassinate them before that, but today they have managed and succeed to kill and assassinate the three Hamas commanders, that according to the confirmation by Al-Qassam Martyrs Brigades.
And
the rescue teams spend
Sorry to interrupt your flow. Can you just be specific and tell us whether the three commanders were hit and killed by the single event, or were they in separate events?
No, they were in one house. This house behind me, the aftermath. This house was three floors, as the eyewitnesses and the residents here told us. And the Israeli airstrikes was heavy shells by 9 rockets, according to the sources here and the eyewitnesses and the residents of this area, which is Sultan. And this neighborhood, Sultan neighborhood, is one of the areas well known in Rafah, full of people, and as you see, it's a residence full of houses. This airstrike targeted this house and caused damage in the whole area, because some of the residents in this house, in addition to the three Hamas commanders, have been killed, and other members and other civilians from the neighborhoods have been killed. According to the Palestinian sources, until now 10 people have been killed in this house, and there is still people searching for some bodies, as they say. Some people are missing. Until now, it's not confirmed information how many people are still missed and in this area. Anyway, Hamas military wing, Al-Qassam Martyrs Brigades, have issued a statement, said that the killing and the assassination of three commanders in Rafah will not stop their retaliations. And after that, they attacked by rockets Ben Gurion Airport. And we heard about some rockets have been fired from different places in Gaza towards some areas, some cities around Gaza and far from Gaza, Israeli cities.
So you've told us that 10 people in total have been killed. Presumably, there were many more people then, perhaps several families in this house. How many houses would you say, how many families have been caught up or perhaps even killed in these attacks? You say 9 rockets killing three senior Hamas military commanders. But what about the other people who were caught up in this attack?
Yes, we, according to the witnesses and according to the medical sources, they said the three commanders and other 7 civilians from the residents of the house has been targeted, and some from the neighbors, because the target was heavy target by F-16, 9 rockets in the same time in this residential area. So, as we heard, three of the victims are children, and two are old men and old women. And we heard about other women has been killed in this attack. Some the bodies were really in pieces because the target was heavy by these rockets. But what we have confirmed, according to the medical sources and the eyewitnesses and the residents, are 10 people, 3 Hamas commanders, and the seven people from the residents of the house and the neighbors, as we heard from here, from Rafah.
Al Jazeera's Tamir Al-Mishal talking to us live there from Rafah, showing us the scenes, the utter devastation as a consequence of F-16 jets firing 9 rockets into a house in which 3 senior commanders from Hamas's military wing were killed.